Well, good evening. Welcome to what is kind of bittersweet for me and perhaps some others as well. This is our last regular concert of the summer season. And the pieces we'll be playing for the most part tonight have been selected by band members as their favorites this year, otherwise known as the concert of the greatest hits. Before we begin, I want to thank those that make these concerts possible. That includes each of you for your support this year, and includes our sponsor for tonight's concert, the Rotary Club of Lake Mills. And I have a yellow sheet I have to plug here. The Rotary would like me to remind you or let you know that on August 17th, there's a free fun festival at Selgin Company down this street, where the fireworks were earlier this summer. There's going to be some vendor booths. There are going to be bands playing. Main Street big band starts in the morning. So cordially invited to come to Music in the Mills on August 17th. Just want to conclude that part with just saying we've appreciated the support we've received this summer and throughout the year from area businesses and individuals as well. So thank you to all of you. I also want to thank a group that I usually fail to mention because they're usually such a thorn in my side. No, I'm just kidding. They're sitting right behind me. Without their willingness to give of time and talent, these concerts just would not happen. I really don't think I would see as many people sitting out there to watch me do this without any band, you know? It's not the same. So, thank you, band, for all you've done this year and previous years. It has been a joy for me to work with you and to see this group continue to grow in numbers. Wow, like somebody ran over my dog. And ability. What most of you in the audience don't realize is that in order for the band members to play these concerts over the summer, they face the reality of having learned more than 70 new pieces, that's 7-0, in order to avoid a lot of repetition in the programs. So once again, I consider myself lucky to be working with this group of musicians. Thank you, band. As I said, tonight's concert consists primarily of a program of pieces played by the band earlier in the summer that they have selected as one of their favorites. I'll call it the program of our greatest hits for 2024. And at first, we're going to start with one that we play every week, God Bless America. Hello?
Thank you.
Didn't feel fully dressed without my baton. I got it. One of the favorites of the band was a piece that we played early on in the season. It's a Carl King march. It was part of a book written by Carl King in early 1942 called Marching to Victory. It was about 3 months after Pearl Harbor, so you get an idea what the theme of the book was. The piece we're going to play from that book tonight is called Aces of the Air. Part of our June 19th concert, we played a medley from the rock and roll group Chicago. Featured in that medley are Make Me Smile, Does Anyone Really Know What Time It Is, Saturday in the Park, and 25 or 6 to 4. Here is pop and rock legends, the group Chicago. Thank you. June 5th concert, we featured some guest conducting by some of our own band members, and we're going to once again feature two of our band members conducting pieces they selected and worked on with the band. First, we're going to invite Dave Province to direct a piece that he has selected for the band. Dave conducted a piece on the June 5th program, a moving arrangement of This Is My Father's World, but we didn't have time for the second piece, and so we're going to have that tonight. He'll present that in a piece that's got a totally different feel from the first one he did. Here is Dave, and he's directing Venom.
As he said, totally different. Venom is a work for concert band inspired by the predators of the animal world that use venom to hunt their prey. It utilizes slightly exotic scale, bombastic drums, and dissonant chords to recreate a musical portrait of an attack by one of these fascinating creatures.
Thank you. Can you hear?
Yeah.
Okay. My name is Ann Hunt. I'm president of the Lake Mill City Band, a highly contested position, as you probably can guess. Anyway, tonight, this last concert is always a fun concert for me because we get to recognize those members of our band who are going on to some sort of education post high school. So we have a scholarship program made possible through very generous donors, as well as just other fundraising that we do. But before I mention or present the scholarship members or winners, I just wanted to mention how much family members of us in the band mean to us in supporting us for all of the concerts, all of the time away. Once the season ends, Mondays and Wednesdays seem kind of empty. And you know, you sit around saying, wow, what am I gonna do tonight? But anyway, so I did, however, want to recognize a couple of family members who really kind of go above and beyond. One is Dave's wife, Chris, our program distributor. Thank you, Chris. Then there's Karen Johnson's husband, Neil, who has rigged up, he's rigged up some pretty innovative ways for her to more readily transport the percussion instruments that he's helped her create. And then I just wanted to recognize my husband, who always kind of, you know, it's, you know how it is. You join something or you're active in something and you know the other half has to participate as well. So thanks, Dan. So this year, for better or for worse, we have a lot of graduating seniors. And what we do like to remind them of is that for those that are awarded a scholarship, and even those that may not have a scholarship, we really enjoy having them, and we definitely want to see them back. We do have a few members in the band who have been around for a long time. One in particular, you can't help but miss the tallest one in the percussion section, Carl Getch. He's been in the band over 12 years. So anyway. So that's the example for your graduating seniors. So what I'll do is I'll introduce each of them and just a little bit on them. Our first recipient winner, and then when I say your name, if you could come up here, and then we'll just all be up here, and I don't know, someone could take a picture, that would be great. I didn't arrange for that. Marilyn, could you do that?
Sure.
Thank you. Okay, so our first scholarship winner is an individual who only joined the band 2 years ago. He's from the metropolis of Johnson Creek, but saw the light and came west. Or is that north? I'm not sure what direction it is. But anyway, so Tyler Shawanek, I'm sorry. If you could come forward, please. Tyler is going to be attending UW-Madison in engineering, so that's another thing you'll learn as we, as I introduce the various scholarship winners. They're pretty interesting and bright futures. So Tyler, thank you. Okay. Next is Tanner Hutchins. Tanner comes from Cambridge. Dave. Okay. Dave Anderson, our director, substitute taught in Cambridge quite a bit. And so he was responsible for recruiting a number of those that are from Cambridge. So Tanner will be at UW-Madison in computer science? Okay. Are you going to be in the marching band? Have you heard yet? Don't know yet. So anyway, watch for him. I think you'll be able to recognize him. Okay. Next is a fellow clarinetist. You'll see a lot of our scholarship recipients are brass instruments, but Eli Rice, also from Cambridge. Eli is going to Blackville, where you'll be majoring in engineering and music.
Minor in
music, so. Is a tuba player, and it's been fun really seeing our tuba section grow, and I don't know, I kind of see it as a testimony to Mike Body, who passed away last year, end of August, and really inspired Carl Keppel, who's also one of our former scholarship recipients. And I think a little bit of Mike rubbed off on Carl, and a little bit of Mike just keeps rubbing off from Carl onto our other tuba players. So Ian Saylor. Another bright star, going to UW-Madison and also graduate or studying computer science. There you go, Ian. Okay. Well, we had to get a female. So our next recipient is has been in the band for a number of years. Her prowess was at recruiting other members. Mackenzie Ziverud, if you could come up. Mackenzie plays French horn. She's going to be going to Martin Luther College, where you'll be, just Luther College, excuse me, where you'll be studying theology and music. Almost done. Next is another trombonist, also from Cambridge, Alexandria Willard, goes by Xander Willard. She is going to be going to MATC in graphic design. So, Xander. But by no means least, the one who's actually been in the band the longest, and a French horn player, so you'll see one woodwind, all the rest brass. So Riley Wolf. Riley is going to be going to St. Norbert's, where she'll be studying biomedical sciences and minoring in music composition. So we wish you all well. We expect to see all of you next year. And thank you very much for being a part of the band.
Congratulations to those guys, and I've enjoyed having them in band, and I hope I will have them in band for, 5, 10, 15 years. Louder? Oh, okay. All right. We're going from a snake bite to something that is a little more subdued. In our July 17th concert, we featured music with stage and screen. And one of the pieces we played, in which you, the audience, sang along, was From the Sound of Music. Here it is again, and guess what? Those inserts are still in your program. We're going to do Edelweiss and hope to hear you singing along. Here we go.
You look happy.
Thank you. Also in our June 5th concert, we featured our tuba section in a familiar polka you all will know. Before we get into it, I just want to briefly say what a pleasure it's been having such a strong tuba section. Carl Keppel, Ian Saylor have done an excellent job for a number of years. And this year we were lucky to have John Mishak join the section as well. So, there, John, your band club has started. All right. Want to thank you. Thank you to all three of them for such a solid foundation of the band, that low sound. So, and they're going to demonstrate it right now with Beer Barrel Polka. Thank you. One of the top vote getters from our July 3rd concert was a medley of Civil War songs by Claire Grunman titled The Blue and the Gray. The medley features 9 songs in both the North and the South. Those include Kingdom Coming, Marching Through Georgia, Tenting Tonight, The Yellow Rose of Texas, The Bonnie Blue Flag, Oralee, Dixie, The Battle Cry of Freedom, and The Battle Hymn of the Republic. You can get the idea that this is not going to be a 3-minute piece. Here is The Blue and the Gray. Thank you.
Thank you.
At our June 5th concert was Karen Johnson. Karen retired from Denmark School District, where she served as band director for over 30 years. At that first concert, she directed a piece titled Vaquero. We really didn't have time for her to direct the second piece she had selected that night. The piece features a French horn section, which is comprised of Jen Kunert, happens to be her daughter, Sarah Togger, Riley Wolf, and Mackenzie Sivrud. Here it is, the horn section tonight, and they're going to be playing a piece that Karen can explain about the horn.
All right, they're kind of shy, too. So this is our horn section, and it's a great horn section. I chose this piece because all too often, a lot of band literature, horns have been kind of neglected, in my opinion, as far as interesting parts. You know, a staple of the band literature is a march. And in a march, we have tubas on going boom, 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 right? And the horns get to go boom, 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 every march. So it's kind of boring. So I wanted you to hear our terrific horn section. So this is called Horn of Plenty. The horn is a very interesting instrument that has got a vast range. And for you quilters out there, I would call them a blending fabric because they work well with the woodwinds. They are a brass instrument, so obviously they blend with the brass. And they work with strings, and they just have this wonderful range that it blends with everything. So we hope you enjoy hearing a horn section. We're going to have, they're not being rude. I intentionally asked them to turn so their bells are facing you so you get the full splendor of their instrument. Okay? Enjoy. Horn of Plenty.
Thank you.
letting them hide behind a post. All right. As long as we're featuring some soloists and sections, we're going to take a minute to listen, well, more than a minute, but to a piece that's tied for the top number of votes from band members. This is a peppy piece featuring the percussion section, specifically two talented young women, Veronica Kressner and Gabby Dressel, and orchestra bells. And they are indeed Mallet Maniacs. Here we go. Well, we're on kind of a roll here with percussion, so the next piece we're going to play is called Pachelbel's Samba. And you'll recognize the canon in D, the Pachelbel theme, but this is a little different. It's got some samba beat to it, some Latin American feel to it. So here it is, Pachelbel's Samba. All right. Amparito Roca is a Spanish march composed in 1925 by a Spanish musician and composer, Jaime Texidor. He named it after one of his piano students, a 12-year-old girl, Amparito Roca. It was first performed in September of 1925. It's one of the better-known Spanish marches, and we played it at our June 5th concert. And this one was tied with Mallet Maniacs as the two top vote getters. So here is Amparito Roca. Medley from Raiders of the Lost Ark was featured in our July 17th concert. This is a medley of two pieces from the soundtrack of Raiders, Marion's theme and the Raiders March, which everybody will recognize, assuming we play it the way we're supposed to. We're going to close with this piece tonight, and thank you very much for a great summer season. Here we go. Thank you. Thank you. We want to thank our sponsor for this evening, the Rotary Club of Lake Mills, and remind you about the music festival on August 17th, just down the street at the Selgin plant. We also want to thank all those who have supported the City Band this year and the previous years. We also thank all of you for being here tonight and all summer. While this is our last summer concert, the band will continue to get together this fall after a little break. Last year we had several holiday concerts. We hope to repeat that this year. We plan to perform, as we have in the past, sometime around the Christmas holidays, maybe between Christmas and New Year's. Watch for that. We'll have it out on Facebook. After that, we'll begin preparing for next summer's concerts in April. And if you thought about joining the Lake Mills City Band, my advice is to act on that thought. You can contact someone in the band or me about your interest. You may contact us through the Lake Mills City Band Facebook page or at lakemillscityband@gmail.com. We have fun. I think you can tell that. And we think you will too, so consider it. Now, if you're able, please stand and join us in the singing of our national anthem. Thank you. And Jolene, why are you down there and not up here?
definitely.